Hello everyone, welcome to my free online tutorial for the new SAT math section. Now the problem that you see on your screen right now is taken from the second exam, second practice test in the official SAT study guide in preparation for the new SAT exam starting in March of 2016 and later, okay? So practice test 2, official SAT study guide for the new exam, question number 1, section 3, where no calculator is allowed, okay? So it test your understanding of algebra, typical algebra problem here. So if 5x plus 6 is equal to 10, what is the value of 10x plus 3? So the first thing that may pop in your mind is that you can solve for x, right? This is the first method that comes to your head. So solve for x and plug in the value into the second expression, right? So you're going to solve for x. If you solve for x, you're going to subtract 6 from both sides. You get 4 on the right side, and then x will be equal to 4 over 5th. And for the value of 4 fifths for the x, you're going to plug it in to the second expression, and you're going to get whatever it is that you're going to get, 11 in this case, right? But let's see the other perhaps simpler ways or faster ways, right? Because you always want to use the fastest method possible to save time for questions that may really get you stuck, right? Hopefully none of them will make you feel stuck, but I mean it can happen, right? So you want to save time. So let's talk about the second method. The second method, and this is my method, and I'm going to talk to you about the third method. This is the College Board method, right, that they outline in their study guide. But the second method is, if you multiply the original equation by 2, right, this one here, you're going to get 10x, you're going to distribute 2, right? You're going to distribute 2 to all three terms, on the left side and the right side. So you're going to get 10x plus 12 is equal to 20. Now you see 10x plus 12 is very similar to 10x plus 3, because the only thing that's missing is that there's a 12 here and there's a 3 here, right? So what do we do? In order to get 12 to equal 3, we're going to have to subtract 9 from 12, right? And to do that, we just subtract 9 from both sides, and we get 10x plus 3 on the left side and 11 on the right, because 20 minus 9 is 11, right? So this is a shortcut that you can use. Okay, now the third method is also a substitution method. It's pretty much the same thing as method 2, except that it's more algebraic. It deals with direct substitution, and I will explain how, right? So they start with 10x plus 3. So they're telling you how we're going to get 10x plus 3 in terms of the original equation. And to do that, they also multiply this by 2. Right, so they multiply. So in other words, they're gonna express 10x plus 3 using some other method, and this is how they do it. They multiply 5x plus 6 by 2, and then they subtract 9 just like we did in the second method, and this whole thing will be equal to 10x plus 3, right? But they don't, of course, they don't expand this, because if they expand, it's going to be 10x plus 3. They leave it as it is, and they're telling you, but remember that 5x plus 6 in these parentheses is equal to 10. So you can substitute 5x plus 6 into 10. And we do the substitution, right? And we get 2 times 10 minus 9 is equal to 11. Okay? So this is the third method. So I'm not sure if which one is faster, but I like my method as well, because it is also a shortcut. You might feel a little bit intimidated by this third method, right? Or you might solve for x, but to solve for x, sometimes it takes more time, because it's a fraction that you're going to get 4 fifths for the x, and then you have to plug in that x, you know, and 4 fifths times 10 is kind of, you know, intimidating for some people who are not mathematicians. So you might as well use my method, because it's really, really easy to see, because 10x plus 12 is so resemblant to 10x plus 3, and the only thing is there's a 3 here, there's a 12 here, so you know that to get 3 you need to subtract 9, and that's it, you get 11, right? So choose the one that you really like here.